From Stanford. Welcome to the 81st APTA National Championships. We are live from the Country Club of Darien in Connecticut on the APTA Network presented by Enet Live. I'm Jerry Viant along with Patty Hogan, and it is time for the women's final. Patty, the crowd is electrified. They're in the hundreds. We've got to get a count. They're waiting for this match up. Can you tell us who we're going to be seeing today?
Jerry, I would love to. We have, I'll start out with the woman in the white pants. But Jerry, I've got to go back a step. I think I have to start with the team in all black, Cynthia Dardis and Amy Shea. And Cynthia Dardis is the deuce court player for her team, number two ranked in the country. They were the second seed in this event. They've come through the draw. Cynthia is a classic deuce court player, real steady, a beautiful tactician. She's a great role player, willing to set up her partner, Amy Shea. Amy brings the forehand and backhand drives off the deck. Both of them are beautiful spot lobbers. They're able to really break down the team on the other side of the net. And I'll look for that to be possibly the difference in this match. On the other side of the net, now I'm going to go to the woman in the white pants. That's Martina Ondrejcova, and she is the deuce court player when they play. She's in the ad court right now with the red sleeves, and she again is the real steady player for her team, a little bit more of a tactician in terms of how their team setups and points go. And she can bring it herself with a beautiful two-handed backhand that I saw her hit hundreds of yesterday to get through into this final match. And she'll be looking to set up her explosive partner, Gabriela Niculescu, who brings one of the game's most powerful offensive shots in her roll overhead that will be a huge part of whether her team has a lot of success today. Gabby has an amazing return to serve as well, and both of these teams kind of set up almost with the role player of a setup player and then the offensive explosions coming from the ad court. And the difference in this match could come down to our deuce court players, both of whom have a great ability to bring offense on their own. Most of the time, for them to get through matches, they don't need that. But I think for Cynthia and Martina to be able to step up and take advantage of some of their opportunities on their forehands could make a difference.
All right, Cynthia Dardis to serve. And there's that first backhand down the line from Martina. Now these guys are head to head this year. Dardis and Shea have won two, and Gabby and Martina have won once. So. 30. All four women are teaching pros in the Connecticut area, so the place is packed.
The umpire does not call the ball out. It's up to the players to make the call there.
That's Amy Shea's on the right at net. And you're going to see her overhead, which is very effective. She really lets that ball drop, sets her paddle early, lets that ball drop, and she comes down the back of the ball. So she's able to keep it deep and low, and she gets some bite on it. You can't attack it at all. All Well, there's the first break.
You'll hear the voice of our umpire, Monty, as we know him in New Jersey. Monty is an amazing tutor. He's the assistant pro over at Montclair Golf Club, and he's doing a great job at these national championships.
Martina to serve. That's what we're going to see, that Gabby's got so much spin on that overhead. She hits that roller and she tends to go hard to the deuce court player's left hip. She's going to make Cynthia have to get out of her own way and find the ball. And that was, they were very successful with that tactic in Chicago in the fall when they had their win. So in order to counter that, Dallas and Shea have to make sure they lob the ball deep and keep them out of the service box when they're hitting their overheads.
Jerry, one other key stat here today, the combined age of the players out here, 104 Dardis and Shea, 64 for Martina and Gabby.
I tell you, I mean, there's a lot of people rooting for both teams, but Dardis and Shea have got the sentimental nod. You know, they've won every tournament there is to win, except the Nationals. They haven't made it past the quarterfinals of the Nationals in their career, so they're not just happy to be in the finals today. They want to add this title.
They have 8 national senior titles together, Jerry, as you know, and Cynthia Dardis even has one more with your friend Sue Tarzan. I'd like to give a shout out to one of our special guests in the stands today. Pam Birmingham is here. She is in the Hall of Fame with her husband, Wooly, and Pam grew up in Scarsdale, and I'll finish the story in a second.
Okay, Amy Shea serving.
So real quickly, Pam was the one who started the growth of paddle in Western Pennsylvania. We just wanted to welcome her here today.
That last play, you just saw the explosiveness of Gabby. She loves to move forward. It's going to be a question of their patience. You know, staying aggressive but controlled, which is always the balance. So these guys really just burst onto the paddle scene a few years ago, so they don't have a lot of experience, but they've got an abundance of talent and desire. The move. It does got to come up with a different strategy. Martina's firing her return of serve like that. Gabby's definitely coming in behind it.
Cynthia's in the I formation here, and they're coming up with a plan, trying to figure out how to defend against the blitz coming from the ad court.
Okay, The laser-like drive that Amy Shay possesses. She will pick the spot, find the hole, find the right hip. I think she got Martina on the hand. Very accurate.
I mean, Cynthia made Amy look so good on that play by setting up that shot, and it's really, you need a succession of shots to break down a team, and it's, you have to just wait for the shorter ball to find the right hip area.
Yeah. They are off to a firing start. Like I said, you know, Gabby, she can attack on both her forehand and her backhand, and she smacks her forehand overhead and, you know, looks to create chaos. So she gets her opponents chasing all over the court. They're not able to balance and pick their spot. And I think that's going to be the play. And it's what Amy and Cynthia can do to battle, combat that. And at the net, you're going to see Gabby serving. She's always looking to pick off her opponent's return of serve.
I mean, this is a great start for Gabby and Martina, and I thought they were nervous about 2 hours ago, but they seem to have settled in nicely.
Here comes Amy, she'll take that shot. Great combination of shots. Once Amy gets moving to the right on a short ball on her forehand, she's lethal. And Shay are masters at controlling the speed of play. They get teams to play into their rhythm. They're not going to get rushed. They're not going to get flustered. They're mentally tough, and they will work the ball. They're good friends off the court, too. It's 41 degrees here in Darien, Connecticut. You know I like to know what the temperature is. It does affect the height of how the ball's coming off the deck and coming off the screen. And I think with Martina and Gabby, you know, really swinging hard.
And I think what Amy Shay just did there in the last couple points is huge, Jerry. I'll explain in one second after the serve.
Cynthia Dodd is serving.
I think Amy Shay can make people look bad on their volleys. A team can appear to be really set up and on their backhands, but Amy has the ability to move the shots side to side, player to player, and gets them looking for a spot. And the more they can do that, get these guys off their backhand volleys, that's going to be a big way for them to come out on top in this match. No.
30-15. No. That's too quick. Return of serve errors. You can't give Amy and Cynthia a chance like that, an opportunity like that. These guys, they love to compete. Watch their body language, it's not gonna change. Nice a little casual. And some team confusion off of on both sides. And that's where knowing where you need to be with your partner on this very small court is so important.
I think we've seen so many matches, Jerry, over the years where momentum plays such a role. And if I had to give an advantage to either team after yesterday, I'd give it to Dardis and Shea, because I saw Martina and Gabby. I mean, they played as high a level as I've seen a set of paddle this year. But then all of a sudden, they'll have a little bit of confusion and breakdown. So Dardis and Shea, kind of steady.
Dardis and Shea got a lot more experience in playing paddle. Gabby and Martina, like I said, they're relatively new to the game, so they're still making the transition of the tactics and the strokes that go with playing paddle. And not a game of mini tennis on the paddle court.
As we can see, Amy just hit three great shots and three volleys came back.
And that's that overhead I was talking about.
Is her slice overhead the most effective in the game right now, Jerry?
Yeah, it's laser-like. I think it's so underrated because, she can hit a dime on the court. So she can take away the offensive weapons with it, and she can also get nicks.
And when you play against explosive players like Gabby and Martina, keeping that ball low off of the overheads makes a huge difference. We see a lot of the down-up overheads, and these women just have the power to tee off on them.
No, they'll spike if they get that opportunity. Martina's just got a beautiful service motion. And she's also got the roller. That's a very tempting angle, but there's no real estate over there. For Martina to go, that's hitting that ball wide. She was trying to get it into Cynthia's corner. And that's Amy making the decision not to let it hit the back side screen. She probably would have ended up by the door. So she chose to block it, but you've got to have your feet under you when you block an overhead that's hit that hard and be able to control it. 15-40.
Jerry, as it's warming up here, do you think that favors one team over the other?
I think it's really going to depend on the height of the lobs. If Dardis and Shea hit short lobs, that warm weather is going to favor Martina and Gabby. They'll be able to put more spin and speed on the overhead and just make Cynthia and Amy move. They have to make them be athletic. There you go. And create confusion and chasing and then volley behind them, but they run the risk if their positioning is not set as a team.
How about that lob from Cynthia? We've seen that a million times. She's a beautiful spot lobber. She knows where to put the ball in the court, break down that net team.
I don't think we're gonna see too many of Cynthia's drop shots. Yeah. Oh. The reason I say that is these guys, there's too much speed. It's going to be hard.
First set tied 3-3.
It's going to be hard for Cynthia to drop that ball when there's that much heat coming at them.
Gabby and Martina have a decent amount of quickness here to cover it. So Cynthia does love that play. I hope she pulls out one, Jerry, just to keep them honest.
I'm sure she will. She'll try. They usually set up so that she's on the right so she can hit that shot. Okay, Amy Shea serving. 3-all, first set. The improvement that we've seen, Gabby and Martina, they're now willing to lob more because they've really worked on their screenplay. When they first came onto the scene, they were driving a lot more and would lose points when the ball went into the screen. Now they're much more willing to set up the lob because they can create offense off of the screenplay.
Dardis and Shea are kind of taking their time here. The servers can dictate play out here. And the key for them is to keep the tempo exactly what you said, Jerry, just what's conducive for their game. And they're showing that right now.
And foot faulting is a big part of paddle. Monty's all over it. He will be calling foot faults. And that's, you often see that because most of our matches we don't play with an umpire, and then all of a sudden you get a call, a foot called on you, and it is unnerving.
Sometimes it's good to have a foot fault called on you early in a match so that you don't get caught late in a match having one called on you.
And just like that. Gabby and Martina come through. They're up 4-3.
Jerry, we've seen so many wonderful paddle matches this weekend. Dardis and Shea had a great win last night over Delmonico and Gebbia, and there was a gigantic crowd here supporting Cynthia and Amy, and that may have been the difference in helping them pull out the match. They had a win in the quarters over Flynn and Moldenville. Gabby and Martina played one of the most amazing matches I've ever seen in their 6-0 win in the quarters over Liz Cruz and Roxy Annika.
Gabby has worked on her serve.
Jerry had some big times yesterday in the quarters and the semis. She pulled out a kick serve that was amazing.
Play Australian. Cynthia yesterday came through with some big forehands. Provided some offensive play out of that deuce side. Martina's got to be careful that she doesn't hit her flat down up overhead, because both Amy and Cynthia will step in and spike that ball down. They're not going to let it go up into the screens.
How many times do people refer to a winning lob? There you saw it, the perfect breakdown shot.
That laser forehand of Amy Shea.
You called it good.
It's flat. Lob volley for Cynthia. Get out of trouble.
There we have it again. Beautiful, well-placed lob from Cynthia Dardis from the Deuce court.
If Cynthia can settle herself and put in four big serves here.
This is a little what I saw in the semifinals last night, Jerry, with Kazakevich and Prop with Martina and Gabby. Kind of up and down play, and it just really could have gone either way in that match. So this is kind of not surprising to me.
Good pressure by Gabby, moving in as soon as Martina struck the ball.
It's hard to keep your eye on the ball and stay composed when that happens.
Right, it was enough for Cynthia to miss that first volley wide, which she normally wouldn't do. It was caused by the pressure of Gabby coming in.
And again, there's that beautiful combination Martina and Gabby have worked out. Return to going low from Martina from the deuce court. Gabby just having that pressure on the first volley. And you start thinking about it even after it's happened. And, you know, that's a big turnaround. Cynthia was a little overeager there on that first volley, and that set the tone for that game.
So what happens sometimes with Cynthia in her serving, she rushes herself. And it's always surprising to me because they do such a great job of playing at their pace during the points. You know, but when it comes to her serving and she gets into trouble, it's almost like she wants to just get it over with. And I think maybe if Amy would go back and talk to her for a second longer, or, you know, give her a positive thought or just a word, you wouldn't see those service faults come in. And I mean, these guys are mentally rock solid. That's just surprises me. Okay, let's see how Martina handles that another foot fault call.
So there are times where Martina does go a little streaky on her serve.
Right, but look at that. Good teamwork. Gabby gives her a high five. Let's go. It's important that you stay positive with your partner. That's one of the things you're looking for at a high level skilled match. Not only the shot making and the strategy, but you're looking for the teamwork. Which team stays together under pressure? Monty's getting a little grief from his fans in the crowd.
Two beautiful lobs, getting Gabby well beyond the service line.
I expect to see a lot of that. They can only do it if Amy and Cynthia hit a short lob. As long as they keep Gabby Martina out of the service box, that play won't come into it. Cynthia called it out, was overruled by the umpire. Players just accept and move on.
It's a rule change from the APTA. It used to be that you would play a let, but now the umpire's call stands.
I think patio players much prefer to have an umpire.
Points go on so long, sometimes it's hard to remember the score, Jerry.
For us, we need an umpire up here.
Well, we've got everything else we need, thanks to ENET Live here in our heated booth for the national championships.
There's the first set. So we're going to take a quick break. We'll be right back in just a moment after these messages right here on the APTA Network, presented by ENET Live.
Paddle's hottest website, paddleplayer.com, has helped revolutionize the sport. Pro video, leagues, tournaments, merchandise, and now state-of-the-art rackets. Visit paddleplayer.com today. Paddle's bright star. PaddlePlayer.com is your go-to website for all things paddle. Articles, videos, instructions, and more. PaddlePlayer.com is your paddle authority. Visit PaddlePlayer.com today.
Presented by ENET Live. We're in the finals of the Women's APTA National Championships at the Country Club of Darien. We just saw the first set go to Gabby and Martina, 6-4. And a big part of the last couple of games was Stardust and Shea lobbing a little short, giving Gabby and Martina the opportunity to showcase their overheads with tremendous pace, tremendous spin, and they're gonna be going after Cynthia's corner in the deuce side. That's a very difficult angle because Cynthia has to get out of her own way, duck, the ball hits the back screen and then shoots up the side screen, so she's gotta duck, and then it's gotta be foot speed. And even when she catches up to it, she's got to know where the ball is in relation to her body. So it puts tremendous pressure on their lobbing. And they're usually known for their deep, high-placed lobs. So we'll see if that changes.
And the more the game changes, Jerry, the more it stays the same, the fundamentals about lobbing and moving the net team beyond the service line is really what it comes down. You have to take away offensive weapons, and that's by getting the lobs a little bit deeper.
Right. Dadas and Shea cannot get into any razzle-dazzle exchanges. They'll come up short. And I think Dadas and Shea have got to take Gabby out of the play right now. They're going to lob. They should lob Martina because she tends to hit more of a flat overhead and a down up overhead, which will give them some opportunities to step in and hit a block lob or a spike. Gabby's going to let it drop and roll it hard no matter what.
Cynthia and Amy said, you know, their key to being able to win this match would be to come up with a formation which would let them take away the weapons, and we've not seen it yet.
Martina's got to let that low ball go through. Gabby's behind her, and she'll volley the ball up. Takes a lot of discipline.
Martina's going to see a lot of balls here. As many as Cynthia and Amy can get over to that deuce corner.
She's firing off of both sides, Martina. She looks very smooth and relaxed to me. They're playing at their speed. Gabby just rushed that forehand.
30-40. Martina knows it. She knows the strategy from Doris and Shea, and I'm proud of her for standing up to it and bringing it on her own.
Overhead by Amy went right back at Martina. You can't get into a quick exchange like that. Dadas and Shea have got to throw up the lob when Martina and Gabby are coming up to the net. They're not going to win those quick, fast hand exchanges at net.
Doris and Shea seem a little perplexed here about what they should do, because Gabby and Martina are playing really at a high level right now. They need to slow down play again, lob above those lights, get some height, slow it down, dictate the tempo.
Yeah, the new kids on the block are on fire.
Well, I watched them all day yesterday, Jerry, and this is not surprising. They had some incredible play all day.
But as we've seen a million times, for whatever reason, Dadas and Shea do not mind being behind. They don't panic.
And I really don't think... I don't think they think it's a paddle match, Jerry, unless it goes three sets. I mean, historically, they are involved in so many long matches.
Oh, yeah, well, they've been out of it. Great hands. No. The Country Club of Darien has really done a spectacular job hosting this national event.
Host pro Carl Levin has just done a great job, and the entire staff here has made us all so welcome. and they've fed us very well.
That's a well-placed lob, pulled Amy all the way to the left. They're looking to open up the court. See, Gabby's hitting those deep lobs and moving to her left, so she has more of her forehand exposed. And that's a big element that she's added to her game this year. Look at her move over to the left. Of course, Martini can drive. A little too much there. Martini can drive through the middle. Takes that safety spot away because her backhand is a huge shot for their team. Oh, we've got some stats from the first set. One of our producers, Kent, will share them with you. 40 in for the first, well, this first set was 48 hits per rally.
That's incredible, Jerry.
It is. I'm kind of shocked by that.
First set tied, 1-1.
1-0.
We're in the second set. Shout out to some paddle fans watching in Philly, led by the Lions. Chatham, the Chatham Chicks are watching, with, led by Jenna McClintock and some Gypsy Trail members with their leader, Steve Greenberg, right here watching the action.
All right, 1-0, second set. Amy Shea serving. Gabby Martina won the first set 6-4. Amy has got to know that Gabby's coming in. Throw up a lob.
And that's where even it is it's the ideal ball for Amy to drive. In this situation, it's not, because Gabby's on top of the net. Amy's got to throw up a high lob, pull Cynthia, get them both in position on the baseline, then build the point from there.
Yep. By driving that, she gives Gabby a point-winning shot. The overhead that we saw Amy use a lot yesterday, that little slider into the deuce corner. She got Fort Lauren moving to the middle a lot and hit it straight in to the back screen, stayed closer to the side screen so they couldn't attack it. Sneaky little shot off the back screen by Gabby. By Cynthia.
30-15. So this little delay might be chalk talk, little rest.
And again, it's good teamwork. Cynthia walks back with Amy. It's no big deal. Got to keep your partner positive if they've just put in a fault. And that is a great play to shut down Gabby's blitzing.
Sometimes
on the ad side with the white hat and black shirt.
And Jerry, sometimes that to make those volleys, it's just guessing correctly.
Yeah. Nice spot drive by Martinez. She got Amy to reach. It was really Cynthia's ball. Cynthia needed to be straddling that line, take it with her backhand volley. That's why that Gabby and Martinez are such a dangerous team, because they can fire off of both sides. Let Martina take it. When it hits the nick, one player that should commit to the side screen. If it pops out behind you, let your partner take it. When you hedge your bets, that's when you get caught. Overheads, nice and deep. Nice digging by Gabby. That's a big hold.
Jerry, one more shout out. I promise this could be my last. To a team from Chicago, Laura Noble and Monica Schenderley. I met them last year at Nationals. I think you were with me maybe at one point in the stands, and they were big fans, and they're pretty new to paddle. They won a match in the main draw here this year and a match in the consolation. They're big fans of Broderick Palmer, and they are part of what makes the national experience so fun, to see these players come back and get better every single year. So much of the focus is on the top players, but with President's Cup and these women and men traveling from all over the country. That's what makes this so exciting.
Yeah, the paddle community. And it's growing. Gabby to serve. 1-2. They won the first set 6-4. That was Cynthia was going to sneak in on the blitz and then changed her mind.
So here we go, and that's where the speed of Gabby's overhead is greater than Cynthia's foot speed. So that's really tough to defend here for any player. Pretty big serve from Gabby there, Jerry. When her confidence is up, I see her going for a little bit more this year on her serve.
Yeah, she's changed her grip more to a continental. She's going for it. 40-15. And again, I love the teamwork. Gabby, Martina coming back, looking at Gabby. No worries. She needs her to keep swinging at her serve.
Ah!
you did a good job of catching up with it, but it's not only that, it's that, you know, your fast feet, slow hands, and where is that ball in relation to your body, and where is your body on the court? So Cynthia really could have let Amy take that.
It's one of the things that happens in paddle. You'll make a mistake that you kind of regret, and then all of a sudden you throw in a quick error for the other team.
Nice, moving forward with her hands up. Love 30.
You just see why these points have averaged 48 hits back and forth.
15-30. Wonder if Gabby's sister, Monica Niculescu, who is a top-ranked women's tennis player on the WTA Tour, is following her sister live streaming in the finals of the Nationals here.
Jerry, you mentioned something that how many countries are watching the live streaming here today? I think the last count was about people from at least 25 different countries.
We had over 20 countries following live stream matches. And back mental errors. You don't want to miss your lobs wide.
That's really one of the few errors Martina has made so far in this match. So there's a lot of cheering going on here, Jerry, even when players miss a shot and they're just trying to boost Stardust and Shea. They have a lot of local support and they pulled them through last night. And so they really weren't rooting for Gabby's error. They were just trying to cheer to encourage Stardust and Shea on, give them a little bit of energy.
And also, you know, there's a lot of great shot making and gets that go into winning the point, and most times in paddle, the point is won in an error. So it's not like they're cheering a fault. They're cheering a series of shots and shot making at the end of the point. Right, Martina to serve, 2-3. They won the first set 6-4.
Great first serve right there to start this game. Even a better shot by Cynthia.
Really impressed with how Gabby has improved her screenplay this year.
It's talk about a get. That was beautiful from Martina.
Martina is, she's just effortless. She floats around the court. I love how she moves, how smooth she is.
Jerry, shout out to one of the game's all-time great screen players and new Hall of Fame inductee, our friend Bobo Delaney. And
any hesitation there in the teamwork.
Gabby had the opportunity to play with Bobo last year in the Nationals, and I think she took away so many great skills that Bobo has shown us for years.
It's that laser-like accuracy that Amy Shea possesses.
Little surprised Gabby didn't follow that play. As Amy went wide, I thought Amy would have slid over to her right. I thought Gabby would have slid.
And again, Monty's overruling, and the players just move on. They thought it was out, the umpire overruled. You've got to take a moment to regroup. And she kind of quick served. And that's the type of opportunity that Amy and Cynthia capitalize on. So now they're up 4-2 in the second set. Gabby Martina won the first set 6-4. Dazzle. Gabby and Martina should use that tactic because they're going to win 9 times out of 10. As you said, racket, ball speed over foot speed.
I think teams, people watching, the viewers are probably wondering, what can Dardis and Shea do here? And some people would think maybe they just give the net up altogether. But the problem is with the overheads that Gabby and Martina have on display, especially Gabby's, you can't really afford to give up the net here.
Again, taking a moment, regroup. Came out with a big serve. The intensity on Gabby's face. Look at the grip she's got, Patty, for a return of serve.
I'm glad I'm on the other side of the screen, Jerry. And that grip allows her to hit those real offensive shots, high point of contact, getting the ball to dip down at her opponent's feet.
Drive from Martina in the middle of the court. Another area where Gabby and Martina have improved tremendously this year is their rhythm off the deck as a team. They have the same timing now when they're taking the balls. Timely net court and the crowd erupts.
The net court brings back fond memories of our friend Dan Strauss-Tucker. Dan used to fire away key moments, and as John Milbank always says, you don't get let cords unless you drive the ball.
Okay, 30 all. Yeah. Great pressure by Gabby coming in. She's coming in with her hands up. It's all set up by Martinez, huge return of serve. You see Martinez sneaking in, putting pressure on Amy's serve. Nice. She put her team in a position of 50-50 there. She was either going to win it or lose it, based on the height of Gabby's return, because she committed to being in there.
And this is the side where Martina and Gabby are so effective. Martina's dipping return, Gabby moving through. And she's got that forehand to move through and cover a lot of the middle of the court.
Yeah, I think Martina just moved forward to put pressure on Amy's serve. To panic when the ball's being thumped at you a million miles an hour. Cynthia did a good job of getting two back, and then the third one, just a little extra juice.
Wow, that was a bold non-volley. So we've gotten past the Gabby onslaught right there, and now this is what Dardis and Che, they can handle this from here. They've got to get through those first couple of shots to start any point on their serving games.
Serving to go up. 5-2, if they win this serve. And that's the speed of Martina's dipping drive, and Amy dropped the paddle head below the level of her hands, and it's warm. I mean, the ball, with that kind of speed, the ball will fly up, so you've really got to make sure you keep your paddle head above your hands.
That's why staying back is a bit of a challenge here as well.
Mm-hmm. Well, I mean, obviously you want to be right on top of the net so you don't have to volley up, but these guys are really moving their lobs around well, as opening up the court. Okay, here's a chance to break. There's Cynthia's overhead. She's picking those spots.
Amy Shea's overhead.
Oh, sorry, Amy, yep. Just amazing. And that's a guest appearance volley. It's so important. It's not what you can reach, it's what's yours. Amy stuck her paddle out, and with the speed these guys are hitting, it's just too hard to control. She just keeps, stay home. Cynthia can volley her own balls. So now we've got the break. Warming up.
I think when you hit those reaching volleys, the ball pops. The temperature's warming up a little bit here, and I think that's why you're seeing a lot of close balls. The players are thinking the ball's going to be good, but it goes a little bit long and a little bit of indecision with the rising temperatures. Gabby serving down 3-4, second set. Gabby and Martina won the first set 6-4. We're at the PTA National Championships at the beautiful Country Club of Darien.
43 degrees, blue sky. We've got some clouds, so the sun is not really an issue right now.
Come back!
Nice duck by Martina. Great get by Gabby. By Gabby. Picked the right spot and then got out of there. Let it go through to Martina.
Again, I like how Martina's taking some responsibility for offense. She was not going to be deterred on that shot. Big serve from Gabby. And those short lobs from Cynthia just looks like we're doing a redo on Enet Live here of some video. It's just happening over and over, and they haven't figured out how to defend it yet.
Very impressive. Very impressive that serve. That takes courage. You know, she's changed her grip. She's going for her serve. And it's one thing to practice that serve on the practice court, but to use it in the final of the national championships, that shows a lot. Davis and Shea. Getting on top of the net there with a penetrating first volley.
And I like what Cynthia did there to hit that volley. She really just ran through the ball. I actually think in this situation that would serve them well. I think you just have to go all out. You're not going to lose a point to Gabby and Martina off a lob here. So you've got to take away the drive, and maybe just getting on top of the net could be a way that they could do it.
Second set.
And right there, that shot from Gabby is the difference from this season, from last season. She didn't hit the ball hard. She just put the ball in play. It wasn't necessary to hit the ball any harder, and it shows a lot of maturity from Gabby here. Great lob from Gabby there.
break point opportunity. Let's go up 5-4.
That was a huge point right there.
Right. From the great serve down the tee by Cynthia.
She got to pull Gabby way over and get control of the first volley.
But, you know, just to be able to put that kind of serve in at that point of the match is...
And even though Amy missed it, did you see where Gabby was, Jerry? Yep. She just took off. Yep. She saw Amy set her paddle face and... She knew she had a beeline to the shot.
Amy will be chuckling about that drop shot. She'll say, I don't have it. Well, I got to tell you, Gabby and Martina are looking very, very confident, playing very smart paddle, playing within themselves and using the weapons that they have that other teams don't have in combination very effectively. Gabby has calibrated the speed of her hits, increased the speed. Martina is hitting her shots off of the deck. She's making her shots. And they're both their screenplays have improved. Let's see if Dardis and Shea can pull a rabbit out of the hat, as we've seen them many, many times before. But Martina's serving.
Really what we're seeing here is a continuation from Gabby and Martina's successes yesterday. It started with that quarter, big win, and they're building from that. All of a sudden this is going way too fast for Dardis Shea.
It's going to the speed of Gabby and Martina. She's got to come up and find it, and then she's got to chase it, and then she's got to be balanced and composed enough to be able to get the ball back when she wants to.
It'd be easier if she were shorter, Jerry. The ball would just go right over her head. Really smart lob volley from Gabby.
That's what we've seen Dardis and Shea do over and over again. They are in there fighting. They change the tactic a little bit. They hit Martina. They lob Martina more. And then when they lob Gabby, they made sure the lob was really high and really deep so they didn't get Cynthia chasing that spin overhead.
That was a great rip by Amy. We've seen it so many times.
Somehow they dig deep, they don't panic, they stay together, they make a tactical change, and here we are, 5-all in the second set. Amy Shea serving, making sure they've got the signals clear.
That's very friendly to Amy Shea right now.
Right, it's very important that Gabby and Martina stay positive and keep that fighting spirit right now. Don't want to back down one inch. To keep doing what's got them that first set.
There's no one who fights like Cynthia Dardis throughout every match I've ever seen her play. It just shows you how much digging in and having that ability to grind out points in matches goes so far.
And self-belief. Switch back, put Amy on the left.
Amy lets that ball drop so low. She's come pretty close to Cynthia's hair a couple times.
Yep. So they put, you know, Amy's on the left, like we talked about a lot, is her overhead's got a lot of spins. She keeps it low, keeps it deep in the court, keeps it low on the screen. And what they're looking for is a weak return, and then Cynthia can move in and hit a drop shot. But Gabby and Martina have done a good job of not letting that play take over. 45.
Beautiful return of serve from Martina there.
On the way up, 40, stepped 30. In, picked her spot.
And Cynthia had moved to her left the last two times on the serve from, going to Martina. So I think Martina was wise there just to stick with the cross court no matter what Cynthia did. And she caught her right hip.
Thank you.
that hard flat overhead from Amy there, Jerry. I think she could hit that a little bit more, maybe even going right at the nick on Gabby. It's risky, but I think it might be a nice play for Amy and Cynthia.
Gabby's hitting some well-placed lobs, nice and deep, caused them to switch. They don't like to be on this side of each other for very long, so I expect a call. There we go, yep, and they don't like their play the other way. Gabby should keep going down the line over Cynthia.
But I just think Amy has some short lobs from Gabby, and she could go right at that nick, and maybe there she can cut one out.
That was a huge hold. So they were on the brink, and now they're up 6-5 in the second set. Gabby and Martina won the first set 6-4.
But this is the finals of the APTA National Championship out of Darien Country Club.
That's what we saw Amy do so well yesterday, is when she's on the left, she can hit those different boards, and she waits to see the deuce court player move over to their left, and then she slides that overhead in. It's deep in the court, and she aims for the nick. So it causes a chase and an opportunity then to open up the court to volley behind the deuce court player.
Jerry, do you think the hometown crowd here is helping Cynthia and Amy, or this is just what they know they can do?
You know, I've said it before, I've had a regular Tuesday match with them at 1 o'clock every Tuesday, and this is how they practice. So it doesn't matter if there's nobody watching or thousands of people watching, this is what they do. Talk about practice with a purpose. They're not just slapping balls around and okay, when it counts, we'll get serious. They practice this mindset.
Wow.
Huge
serve. Two misses by an inch on both sides.
Huge serve from Gabby. Really love how she's going after her serve. That just looked like Cynthia was pushing the ball back in play. She pushed it at Gabby's left armpit. When you're coming in from the serve, that's an awkward volley to control sometimes.
A huge play for Amy to sneak over there and kind of pick Cynthia's pocket and take that shot. Another overruled by our umpire, Monty. He's doing a great job. He's decisive on the spot, moving this match along. And that was a huge point to not put the ball in play. We're always taught, Jerry, don't you teach everybody, play anything that's close, even right here, because every point is critical. All of a sudden, it's a big swing, and we might get a tiebreaker instead of Darz and Shea heading into the third here.
Right. That, I am so impressed with Gabby's serving right then under clutch moments. She went for it. So we're in a tie break. First team to 7 by 2. Gabby Martino won the first set 6-4. We're down a set point. Cynthia gets one serve, and then they're going to change ends. And from here on, every server will serve twice. Martina serving, one love.
And Cynthia did all she could there. She went up the side screen, just a little unlucky. Little chats with both teams on the same page here. Great to see.